Hello everyone, and welcome back to From Our Basement Gaming.
Hi everybody.
We are back with part 87 of our Ecco the Dolphin Defender of the Future Let's Play.
Yes, we're back.
And at the time of this upload, not at the time of recording, it's Connor's birthday, so happy birthday.
Oh wow. Well, I had no idea. It's years bleed in for me. 35 years. It's been 35 years. I'm gonna do that again.
Well, you didn't have to say your age, but that's okay.
You're right. I didn't have to say my age. Sorry, everybody.
No, don't apologize. I just didn't know if you wanted our audience to know, but...
Well, if we want to censor it, can I?
You don't have to, no. It's up to you.
Yes. Still game after all these years.
It has been a constant part of our lives.
And it has.
I'm glad we're able to share it together.
So am I.
Ed Annunziata, the creator of Ecco the Dolphin, on his Twitter, he made a comment about an article that was like the top 10 Sega Genesis games that put Ecco at number 9. And he said, only number 9? You know, something like that. Yeah, so I responded to his comment saying that Dolphin and Tides of Time will always be my top 2. I said even more than Sonic the Hedgehog 2, which is my number 3. Which is the truth, you know. And apparently he had responded to that and said, and I paid you nothing, right? Really cool.
Fine.
Yeah. I just thought it was cool because this is the... Yeah, the guy who made Ecco the Dolphin in this, even though he followed my Twitter, which is really cool in itself, to have the creator of Ecco the Dolphin following him, because he's actually a really cool guy from what I've seen. He doesn't give that vibe of, I'm better than all of you, you know. He, he gives that.
I would have that.
He gives that friendly uncle vibe, I feel like. You know, maybe a little bit quirky, but your friendly uncle vibe. But anyway, he's never commented on any tweets I did before, so I thought that was really cool. But he commented on a comment I made.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah, I was really starstruck. Even if, you know, maybe to a lot of people, he's not really a celebrity per se, he'll always be one to me. So,
he is. Yeah. He is a celebrity, especially to us.
Yeah.
I mean, he played video games, he was crucial in Sega's development, and the third game that was inspired by his brother.
Yes. Yeah. Sadly, he wasn't involved in this one, but.
He can play this and. Played both of his games. They were the first games we ever played on this channel.
Yes. That's how important Ecco is to me. Hmm. Did you change it to be level 3 marking?
Yeah, it should be. If not, then we'll backtrack. Talkative friends are like, hey, how are you?
Right. Hey, how are you?
Pretty much, or something like that. But basically, it's not that difficult. I figured out one of the other mistakes we made, which was we didn't actually know which door we had to go through. But now I do know how to go through.
This far, so we're not gonna see.
Yeah, it would be stupid to stop right now.
Yeah, I mean, we took a brief hiatus to do Sonic 2 and Sonic CD, but you know,
right.
That was just a special occasion.
So.
Well, yeah, we did take the break to do Sonic 1 because that one was not a sequence. Which, you know, we were up front that since this is a long let's play, we might have to take occasional breaks because it can be a frustrating game.
The rewards of completing it are not what the fans like it is, but sort of keeping it going.
Yeah.
Sign. Oh, sorry.
No, you're good. Someday we're going to have to write out ahead of time. you heard anything about this power sphere, sir? Suddenly, the Exalted One has by now learned its secrets.
The mistake that we made last time was we didn't know which specific door we had the freedom to go through when we got the right stamp on our body. And as soon as we get it...
So now, did you look at anything for the next level?
I...
did not?
Did not know.
Okay.
But I did... tackle this, and basically you want to go through this door right here, because this is going to open up. Yep, see? And in here, the doorway that's open we want. Powers of levitation.
Alright.
I'm hearing nervous laughter from...
And not nerve... No, no, not nervous laughter. Just kind of like a... They have this little bonus thing that doesn't really mean anything, but it's just there. A giant machine in the middle of the stage at its midway point until you see a health glyph. Enter the structure below this item and start swimming downward. Near the bottom will be a tunnel. Take it and follow it forward until you reach a room with a clan member floating under some bubbles. Talk to that Welcome, sir. You must be new to this facility. I am the engineer in charge of the generator. So, I guess you're going to... It says talk to the enemy in this room and watch her exit. Then slowly follow. What? But this in the middle has some like bonus thing. It says, let's play some soccer.
Soccer?
But it really adds nothing to it. It's just a little Easter egg, I guess you could say. Yeah. Says, but it just breaks up the whole thing, so I don't know what it means. It says, to find the special bonus, you've got to first go into the hidden chamber, past the clan member in the center of the giant machine, then touch the far right yellow light with your nose. There's no real reason to play this one-on-one game, but it's still a fun way to waste some time. Checking to make sure all the systems are off. We must not let the resistance use it or reach the exalted ones. So, I do not know. No, because it's mentioning following this enemy dolphin and not to get ahead, but to keep a moderate distance behind. When she leads you outside of the machine and into a coral reef, get a bit closer. She'll then go into one of the tubes sticking out of the sand. Quickly find it before the hatch closes and you'll be in a prison for one second. Person is the engineer. This part says find the engineer, but this one says find your friend.
Well, the engineer appeared green on their radar, which, if I remember correctly, friendly critters are green and hostile critters are red.
Yeah.
Ecco is blue.
So do we have to look for a red guy then? Because, yeah, you can't do the thing with the engineer until you do this first part.
So it has to talk with the red.
Yeah. Because then you talk to the engineer, which the book has assigned the male gender. And I guess the enemy, they assigned a female gender. Kind of suspicious. Wonder why how they decided. Just being random, I guess. Because I don't think he's other than like I'm pilot and I'm pilot's mother. Some of them. have an advantage.
Yeah.
Make me scared. Die from this bit. Yeah. Speaking of which, there's going to be a fourth despicable me movie this year. I know.
Despicable Me 4. Yes, we made yet another.
I didn't even watch 2 and 3 that still kind of had humans in it.
That's a shadow. Despicable Me 4. Made yet another one. Can't get enough of it.
I guess I feel like watch the second one because they already knew how marketable the minions were, so I felt... Yeah, so I felt like the movie would probably focus too much on the minions, and... I'll be honest with you, they're fine in the first movie, but they're not really that funny to me.
Talk about love and romance in the second movie. Surprise! The guy you were supposed to assume he was a bad guy is the bad guy. Da 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 da.
I'm guessing you saw the second movie.
Yeah, I did see the second movie. Twitch.
So I guess I didn't miss it.
Well.
And it's funny, I like the movie, I really do, but. If they kept it the way the first movie was, where the minions weren't the main focus, it would have been okay.
Yeah, I would have preferred that to hear what they were doing.
Excuse me, I cannot talk now. I must conduct an inspection of the facility. Do not pursue me. I have my orders, and they are not your concern.
Okay.
That's very funny.
Yes, because I'm happy.
Well, no, don't go ahead.
What?
You're supposed to follow. Just wait. Although it looks like they're deep. Help you now. I must resume my inspection. Do not interrupt it.
Okay, so that's what we're doing.
Still weird that they randomly sent shooters.
Oh golly!
Our cable went out again.
That's definitely going to be something I'm probably gonna have to replace ASAP. Okay, so where is that dog going? Yes. Am I really Ecco the Dolphin? Good, we're back.
I hope we don't have to start over.
Same.
Oh, wait. Yeah, you probably want to start over.
Well, that's an error thing. This guy?
No, that's the engineer, I guess.
Right.
So we need to go back. I'm guessing.
I noticed there were a few other rooms.
Yeah, well, you're going to... So, you want to follow until it leads you outside the machine and into coral reef. Get a bit closer, she'll then go into one of the tubes sticking out of the sand. Quickly follow before the hatch closes and... ask me to help get the machine running. The machine that eventually will lead us to the princess. So yeah, more than likely this will have to be concluded in the next.
Well, this would not be material.
We do have 2.5 minutes. Yes. It's definitely an interesting structure. Everybody was happy. Yeah, fun of random mission.
Yeah.
I just don't remember.
All I remember is that she was voiced by the lady who played Ginger.
Yeah. Very interesting. I learned about the Johnny Test pilot, and apparently in the like pilot that I guess was just originally just shown to like the company, I guess, you know, inside pilot. Kenny was Dookie, the dog, that just in the test pilot. But he wasn't the final voice of it.
Wow.
Yeah. Which I'm like, it was weird because I'm used to whoever did the in the show. The
guy who comes off as a
Yeah, but I like him. He fits too.
Yeah.
Tom Kenny, I love Tom Kenny's voice, but his voice doesn't suit. But anyway, we are actually we could at least, we'll try this one more time, and if we get lost, we'll just do it.
Oops.
yeah, we. I guess we'll just stop here and we'll conclude next time.
Okay.
All right, guys. Well, we made some progress, and we will see you in the next part. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Bye.